again and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So for today's video, I am going to make a summary of chapter 10 entitled Application Layer. Guys, this chapter explains how the function of application layer, session layer, and presentation layer works together to provide network services to end user application. It also describes the features and operations of well-known applications layer protocol that allows for file sharing services including FTP, FSS or file sharing services, and SMB protocol. It also explained how data is moved across the network from opening an application to receiving data. Did you know, guys, that this chapter will explore the role of the application layer and how the application services and protocols within the application layer make robust communication across data network possible? And guys, we have three primary functions in presentation layer. First, we have formatting and presenting data at the source device into a compatible form for receipt by the destination device. Next, we have compressing data in a way that can be decompressed by the destination devices. And last, we have encrypting data for transmission and decrypting data upon receipt. In session layer, as the name implies, function at the session layer create and maintain dialogues between source and destination applications. Next, guys, let's discuss what are the three common message types. So first, we have GET or GET. It is a client request for data. A client sends the GET message to the web server to request HTML pages, while in POST or POST, it uploads data files to the web server such as form data. And last, we have PUT or PUT. It uploads resources or contents to the web server such as image. And one of the primary services offered by an ISP is email hosting. To run a computer or other devices, email requires several applications and services. And did you know, guys, that in SMTP message format, it requires a message header and a message body, while the message body can contain any amount of text, the message header must have a properly formatted recipient email address and a sender address. And did you know, guys, what is POP or PAP? So PAP is used by an application to retrieve mail from a mail server. With PAP, mail is downloaded from the server to the client and then deleted on the server. this is how PAP operates by default. In IMAP or IMAP, it is the another protocol that describes a method to retrieve email messages. Unlike PAP or POP, when the user connects to an IMAP or IMAP capable server, copies of message are downloaded to the client application. The original message are kept on the server until manually deleted. While in DNS protocol, it defines an automated service that matches resources names with the required numeric network address. It includes the format for queries, responses, and data. And did you know, guys, that DNS uses the same message format for all types of client queries and server responses, second for error messages, and third to transfer of resource record information between server. And the DNS server stores different types of resources records used to resolve names. This record contains the name, address, and type of records. Some of these records type are: A is for an end device's IPv4 address, NS an authoritative name server, AAAA or A sub 4 an end device IPv6 address, and MX is a mail exchange record. Did you know, guys, that DNS protocol uses a hierarchical system to create a database to provide name resolution? The hierarchy looks like an inverted tree with the root at the top and branches below. And the FTP or File Transfer Protocol is another commonly used application layer protocol. FTP was developed to allow for data transfers between a client and a server. An FTP client is an application that runs a computer that is used to push and pull data from an FTP server. While in server message block or SMB, it is a client-server file sharing protocol that describes the structure of shared networks, resources such as directories, files, printers, and serial port. It is a request-response protocol, and it is a SMB message share a common format. This format uses a fixed size header followed by a variable size parameter and data component. Guys, my video of summary of chapter 10 are almost done, and I hope you gain knowledge. So thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.